Yeah, the highway's right behind us, and we're actually sitting on top of acres of farmland. Tonight, all of it is underwater. And for a better look at the devastation of these floods, we wanted to show you by boat and by helicopter. The relentless Missouri River spilling out of its banks.
You kind of see the water rushing over.
And forcing hundreds of families out of their homes.
It's a massive amount of water. It's kind of unbelievable. You know, seeing it up here from the air kind of puts it in perspective.
Barrick Embry is a pilot who's made frequent trips out to survey the damage.
The other day, actually, I noticed some people at their house pulled up next to it in the boat, you know, hauling stuff out of their house to try to save it.
From hundreds of feet in the air, we followed the Missouri River.
It is kind of hard to tell because there's water everywhere.
Finding broken levees and disappearing farmland.
Everything on the right should be dry, except for what's right below us. Even out there, all in front of us should be dry.
Volunteers spent days doing what they could to slow down the floodwaters and keep their homes dry.
There's a bunch of, because a lot of places on the levee, they'll stack sandbags and plywood to kind of keep the, bring up more height.
But we found four separate spots where the levee broke.
So that levee broke right there, and it's really rushing through there, and it's kind of amazing to see the raw power of the river, how it can just tear through just about anything.
Thousands of acres of farmland now underwater.
There's a lot of damage, and I know a lot of people worked hard on the levees trying to keep the river held back, and then to still have all this happen is pretty demoralizing.
Embry says he keeps hope and waits for the water to recede.
That's quite a big hit here.
And back here live, I can tell you that we were out here about a week ago, and it's almost unrecognizable from this time about 7 days ago. Now, coming up at 6, we're actually going to stay in this boat. We're going to take you out and show you some of the homes and how they're dealing with this flooding coming up at 6 o'clock. Nicole D'Antonio, Fox 4 News.